Welcome. In this class, we'll be exploring mudras. Mudras are hand positions or body positions which allow us to tune to specific subtle energy frequencies within our being. It is a symbolic gesture, and using the mudras helps manipulate prana in physical, mental, and the pranic body, the koshas, if you're familiar with those, the anamaya, manomaya, and pranamaya koshas. Using mudras affects each of these layers. It is also translated as seal, like to seal something off. In a way, the mudras recirculate prana throughout our body, and based upon the mudra, which fingers or how they're positioned, whether they're extended or whether they're together, all changes that recirculation to different nadis or channels. So within our body, we have five elemental energies. We have space, we have air, we have fire, we have water, and we have earth. And as I count them off, I'm counting on my thumb for space, first finger for air, third finger for fire, ring finger for water, and pinky for earth. So all the nadis in our body, channels, pranic channels that carry energy in our body, terminate at our fingertips. So when we bring the fingertips together, that channel is sealed into a mudra, and the energy becomes recirculated. So that's just a little introduction to mudras and how they work. This class is mostly experiential, so we'll go ahead and get into the practices. First, we'll do a little breathing to center ourselves. So find that you're in a comfortable seated position where you can feel supported in your spine. If you're away from the wall, make sure that your hips are even. And if you're at the wall or sitting in a chair, feel that you are being supported by the chair, not that you're relaxing into it so much, as you are still holding yourself up, and it's there supporting you in that. So take a nice deep breath in and a nice deep breath out. Nice deep breath in again. A nice deep breath out. And then release the breath, let it happen naturally. And become aware of the breath. Become aware of the sensations that you feel in your body as you breathe. You can move your awareness around, maybe starting at the tip of the nose and feeling the air move in and out of the nostrils. Maybe feeling the rise and the fall of the chest. Maybe you feel the ribs expanding, the diaphragm expanding and contracting with each and every breath. Again, not controlling or forcing, just letting the breath happen naturally and observing what happens as it does. Allow the face to soften, the jaw to relax. On the next exhale, just let yourself relax. Release any tension that you do not need to carry, internal or external. Let your whole body soften, whole mind soften, whole energetic being soften and relax. And begin to deepen the breath a little bit. Bringing some conscious awareness and guidance to the breath. We'll begin with our first mudra by bringing our thumb and ring finger together. You can rest your hands on your legs or wherever is most comfortable for you. Allow the arms and the shoulders to remain relaxed, and allow the hands to also remain relaxed. Just using the energy necessary to hold the thumb and the ring finger together. And keep the eyes closed and focus on any shift that we can notice in this mudra. So this is the earth mudra. It's connected to the muladhara chakra, root chakra at the base of the spine. So this brings grounding earth energy. If we think about earth, it's heavy, it's soothing, it's nurturing. And grounding. So we're feeling that grounding energy collecting at the base of our spine, extending down into the earth. keeping your awareness and your attention, focusing on the grounding earth energy, and paying attention to what that feels like in the body. The next mudra that we'll move to is the water mudra. We'll bring our thumb and our pinky finger together. Now the other three fingers will come to be together. So instead of having them extended out away from each other, bring the three fingers next to each other. Now the thumb and the pinky finger touching. So different qualities for water than for earth, right? Water is flowing and moving, and it's a little lighter than earth. Fluid. And this then connects to all the fluids in our body. Blood, lymph, saliva, digestive juices, anything that flows and moves in liquid form in our body will benefit from this mudra. Here we're focusing on this Vajrasana chakra, the sacral chakra, in between the hips. Again, thinking water element and noticing how this mudra has changed the energetic feeling of your body. Bringing your attention back to the breath. Using that as your anchor. Noticing, observing. Breathing, sensing, feeling, resting, allowing. The next mudra we'll move to, and bring our ring finger, fold it down towards your palm, and bring your thumb over the ring finger. So, kind of on your second phalange. The first and second finger are still together, and then the pinky is up. And this fire mudra. What are the qualities of fire? Fire is lighter than water. Fire is converting, metabolizing, transforming, discriminating, heating, it also provides light and clarity by providing light. So here, feeling again even a little bit lighter than the water, focusing on the Manipura chakra, the solar plexus. Maybe even visualizing a glowing, radiant sun in our center of our being. Holding our passion, our power, our strength, our vitality. Empowering us. And come back to the breath. Circulation of prana to happen uninhibited by thought. Just being really present with your breath, really present in your body, just sensing and feeling, absorbing. Let it all in. The next mudra we'll move to, we'll bring the fold, now the first finger, and bring the thumb over top the first finger, so you're making like a ring. And then the other three fingers, middle ring and pinky, are still together. And also noticing just if your hand, what kind of tension is uncomfortable in any of these positions? Maybe the fingers don't want to stay straight. So just encourage them to be as straight as they can while also remaining relaxed and not holding tension in the hands or the shoulders. And come back to the breath and start to experience this mudra. This is the Vayu mudra. Vayu is air. And what are the qualities of air? Air is light, even lighter than fire. Expansive, expanding, flowing, moving, clear. It can also be cool, create friction. So it can be rough and dry. Now we're centering our energy into the heart, Anahata chakra. Just focusing on the breath, noticing, sensing and feeling. Resting in the heart. Move to the next mudra, bringing the middle finger to the thumb, extending the other fingers out. Akasha, space, ether, what holds everything else. And even notice, feel in your hand how this shape feels more open and expansive. Here we're centering in the Vishuddha chakra, the throat chakra. What are the qualities of space? Even lighter and even more expansive than air. It is the container for everything else. No end, no beginning. And completely unified. Notice in your being, feeling even lighter, feeling that expansion within yourself, feeling the clarity and the freedom of having space to express freely, knowing that you'll be held and accepted exactly as you are. Again, make sure the hands are relaxed, only using the energy necessary to bring the thumb to the middle finger. Everything else is relaxed. Bring the thumb to the first finger, forming a large circle. The other fingers are extended and relaxed. Bringing your attention to the Agnya chakra, the third eye, feeling connected and centered, focused, and come into your mind's eye and watch from here. Rest here in the all-knowing eye. We'll bring the left hand to rest in the right hand, wherever it's comfortable for your hands to rest. And bring the thumbs together, just slightly touching. Again, left hand resting in the right hand, palms facing up, and then the thumbs gently touch. Representing wholeness, balance, and unity. Coming into the Sahasrara chakra, the crown chakra. Wholeness and unity within our whole being, extending out into the cosmos. Feeling the light expansiveness of our true nature. Holding ourselves in loving light. Feeling integrated and whole. When you're ready, slowly bringing yourself out of the meditation in your own time and way, maybe staying here longer.